to present more NFL action. I'm Al Michaels, along with my partner, John Madden.
This is a steady offense that will try and wear you down every time they have the ball. Got a solid offensive line, they can control the clock. They love to use the running backs and tight ends in the passing game. Given 5 to 10 yard gains to keep the ball moving methodically down the field. Being put in motion a lot too.
John, this defensive unit plays every game at top intensity. They have a strong front seven and are extremely tough up the middle. That being said, they know their pass defense has to get better, so they've taken steps to improve in that department and have used a more frequent rotation of defensive backs.
Now this is what you call excitement. Look at those guys down there. They can't even stand still.
They're lined up for the kickoff, so let's get today's game started. The Colts are ready to kick this one off.
You got all of that.
From the 2 yard line to the 20. They're ready to go on offense for the first time.
Number 10 on the turn.
It's first and 10. Harrington with a man in motion. With the carry. Big pop that time.
You want someone there to tell you to watch out because he just got decked.
He might have gotten a yard or two.
That guy got knocked around by that defense. He needs a little protection from his lineman.
Second and 9. Gets rid of it. And it's caught. Brackett is the guy who's there to bring him down at the 34-yard line. Harrington throws that pass for a gain of 7. Jill Harrington with her report from the sideline.
I was able to catch up to Coach Dungy earlier today, and he told me that the key on defense will be getting after the quarterback. They have to turn up the intensity and make some plays in the backfield here in the first half in order to set the tone for the rest of the game.
All right, Jill, thank you for the update. Again with the run.
Yeah, he wasn't about to let the runner juke him. Watch the center of his body span. You hit him solidly, just like you're supposed to do in a one-on-one situation.
So we have first and 10 here. Again, Brackett with the tackle at the 44-yard line. He was fortunate to get anything on that play.
And that's a tribute to their strength and conditioning coach. These guys spend almost as much time in the weight room as they do on the field. And you see it pay off when a guy can turn a play that looks like a sure loss into a play for a couple of yards.
Waves it off again. Doss records the tackle at the 47. Gain of 4. Third and 3. They'll go from the I formation. They give it to the halfback, setting up play action. Rowing. The pass ball's incomplete. Plenty of pressure, and he barely gets the pass away.
And the guys up front got good pressure, forcing him to get rid of that one before he wanted to.
Sets up to run back the punt. Here's the punt. He's waving for the fair catch. And they're ready to go on offense for the first time. Much anticipated matchup. John is one of the best quarterbacks in the league. Takes on one of the top defenses in the league.
Yeah, this is going to be a good one, Al. If this defensive line can get some penetration early, especially from the weak side, I think they're going to have a chance to get some sacks and hurry the passer. You can't let the quarterback set up back there, or this guy will just tear you apart.
Dropping back to pass on first down. Throws it. Incomplete. He barely got that one off.
They did a nice job up front with their bull rushes and rips and stunts, forcing adjustments along the offensive line. They have to do a better job getting off the ball, controlling the line of scrimmage. But they're going to have a tough time whenever they drop back to throw.
The Lions come out in a nickel package, calling an audible now. James. They'll go with a play fake. Gets rid of it, and he hits his target, and he just got level.
Yeah, you know that whole deal about what happens when an unstoppable force meets an immovable object? Well, the unstoppable force won that one.
First and 10. James, the lone setback. Calling an audible. James. James didn't have much to work with on that one.
That's because the defense did a good job anticipating the snap count. With an aggressive defense like this, a hard count could be an effective way to keep them off balance while trying to draw them offside.
Manning sends a man in motion. Looking for the long completion down the left side. Pass ball's incomplete. Third down. I'm coming after that long pass ball's incomplete. Fifth play of this drive. For a receiver, incomplete, and he drops an easy one. Swinton is the deep return man. Here's the kick. From the 34. So we have first and 10 here. Jones. Ooh, that one will leave a mark.
He got caught. I'll tell you one thing, he's going to feel that in the morning.
Pulled down after a minimal gain.
They just manhandled him at the line of scrimmage. I always say that if you win the battle in the trenches, it's going to go a long way towards your winning the game.
Simmons goes in motion. Freeney got very good penetration there. Couldn't get around the corner on that one.
Yeah, and he should have turned upfield a little bit sooner. By the time he tried to cut that one upfield, the defense had him right where they wanted him.
It's third down and 10 to go. Indianapolis comes out in a dime package. Throwing. He finds his man. He was really hit hard on that play.
Yeah, you talk about your depleter. That's what happened there. He unloaded and he got a depleter.
Play to the left. Jefferson with the stop at the 49. And a pickup of about two. They have to get the ball inside the 42 to convert. The Colts come out in a dime package. Closing in, gets rid of it, right to him. Bashir breaks the play up in the backfield. But the pass but didn't go anywhere.
Nope, they were on him like glue.
Third down and long coming up here. The Colts come out in a dime package. With the pass, and it's complete. Harper records the tackle at the 38.
Watch it here. This is a great call on third down to keep this drive alive. They were in a tough spot here, but this is a heck of a throw and catch to pick up that first down.
Sides, and we'll start the second quarter. First and 10. Tosses it out to the right. Doss takes him down at the 33-yard line, and they're trying to force the defense to adjust to them.
If they keep getting gains like this, it could really open up things for them in the second half.
They need five. The Colts come out in a nickel package. With the pass. Incomplete pass. Not much touch on that pass.
He may have tried to put a little too much oomph on that throw.
Ninth play of this drive. The Lions line up with two backs behind the quarterback. John is still trying to move the ball on the ground.
This is a tough physical team that likes to run the ball in just about any situation. When you can run the ball consistently, it really wears down the interior line and helps to slow down those pass rushers.
Hanson comes in to attempt a field goal, which would give them their first score of the day. And it's on its way. The veteran kicks it through.
No problem for him. Whatever the situation, he'll approach it the same way. Cool and smooth.
The Lions are lined up for the kickoff.
Rhodes back deep to return.
Not a bad kick, they'll set up for the return. From the 13-yard line. The offense takes over after they were unable to get any points on their last drive. So they have first and 10 here. Looks like he's changing the play. Gets rid of it. In and out of his hands. The little lob doesn't find its intended target. He sees something in the defense. Manning with a man in motion. Calling an audible. Change.
It's first and 10. Pollard in motion. James. Pressure. Throwing on the run. Right to him. And he is bumped out of bounds at the 47. So they get two first downs on their last two plays.
They're getting it done by seeing the whole field and taking what the defense gives them.
Ball on the 47-yard line. Only one man in the backfield. They give it to the halfback. The 40. Walker makes the tackle at the 37. 9-yard gain. They'll have to get the ball inside the 37 in order to convert. Under pressure, throwing, and it's caught. Nice read, finding the receiver who is in single coverage. First and 10. Hands it off to the back. He's brought down behind the line for a short loss. The interior lineman, John, got off the ball very well on that play.
Yeah, and the key to stopping that kind of run is exactly that. Whoever fires off the line faster and gets better leverage is going to win those battles at the line.
Detroit comes out in their nickel package. Kant pulls him down at the 30-yard line. Short gain on that burst through the middle, maybe half a yard.
I don't think I'd call that run a burst. That was more of a limp up the middle.
Third down and long coming up here. James, the deep back. Throws it. Incomplete. And the cornerback is able to tip it away from the intended receiver.
He got a good sense of knowing where the ball will come down and when to make his move.
Vanderjagt lines up for the field goal to try to put them on the board for the first time in the game. And it's up. That one just barely got over the crossbar.
He's one of those guys who really works hard at what he does. And you can see that hard work paying off when you make a kick like this one.
Nice kick and returnable from the 10. The Lions will start the drive from the 25-yard line. Two-minute warning coming up. Rodgers comes in motion. With the carry, setting up play action, gets the pass off, almost a big turnover.
One thing remains constant. No matter what kind of quarterback you are, rushing your throws is going to end up in incompletion or worse.
Almost at the two-minute mark now. They'll go from the I formation. Pressure coming, slings it to the outside. Stop behind the line, loss of a couple. But the pass but didn't go anywhere.
Yeah, the defense is real good at putting a quick end to completion.
2 minute warning coming up. Two minutes to go. Harry Farrington back in the shotgun. Dropping back, looking for a receiver with the throw, and it's complete. Good read finding the single coverage in the secondary. Changing the play now. Going to the air on first down. Gets the pass off. Incomplete pass. A little bit long, overthrowing the receiver.
He has to learn to take a little bit off it sometimes. You don't want to try and guide it in there or put it up for grabs, but you also need to give your guy a chance to catch the ball.
And this is the fifth play of this drive. With the pass. Turns, he has it. Brackett with the tackle at the 49. They'll call this play at the line of scrimmage. Throws it. This pass is incomplete. Harrington had to unload that pass in a hurry.
So many passing attacks in the NFL rely on timing. When you can put pressure on the passer, you never give him a chance to get into a rhythm. And you force him to throw the ball before he wants to.
Come out in a dime package. With the pass, and it's caught. Brockett is proving again why he's one of the quarterback's favorite targets. That's his fourth reception. They'll go with a hurry-up offense. Throwing. He finds his man. Jefferson makes the stop at the 37-yard line. Let's see how this defense handles the no-huddle. Surveying the field. Throws it over the middle. The defender brings him down at the 10. Troy calls a timeout. They have two remaining.
Red zone opportunities are always a big factor, and they should get at least a field goal out of this drive, as long as they're careful with the football.
Indianapolis comes out in their nickel package. Tosses it left. Thornton gets right in there and brings him down. And now a second down play as they continue to try to get into the end zone rather than settling for a field goal before the half. 12 yards needed to get into the end zone. Harrington scans the defense from the gun. Looking for an option. Lobs one into the end zone.
This is just a beautiful play to force the incompletion. I mean, he gets up high, and he turns what could be a touchdown into a heck of a defensive play.
Third and long. Do they gamble here or just keep it on the ground?
With the score being as it is, it might just be better playing it safe. But that's the coach's decision, not ours.
Fitzsimmons in motion. Throws it. The pass was incomplete. The quarterback thought he had that one.
You got to deliver the ball out there quickly, but it has to be catchable. You got to use some touch.
Jason Hansen lines up to attempt a 29-yard field goal. The kick is up. Hansen bangs that one right through, his second field goal of the game. The Lions are set to kick it deep. Decent kick. We should have a return from the 10. Last drive stalled, and they settled for a field goal. Now let's see what happens.
Hey, here's where efficiency is the key. They're down right now, but if they score before the half, it'll really help them out. They just can't afford a turnover that gives the other team a chance to increase the lead.
Nickelback in this time. Closing in, gets rid of it, and he makes the grab. And so a risky call to send the corner backfires, and they give up a first down.
Some quarterbacks love blitzing corners. because they know that there's one less cover man out there and they have a lot better shot at hitting someone in stride.
The Colts line up with two backs behind the quarterback. Dropping back to pass on first down. With the throw, incomplete. Good call by the defense as they set the corner on a blitz.
He just had too much pressure in his face to see anything, and he threw one out there. Lucky for him, it wasn't picked off. There's only one way that they're going to be able to do something about this score. Keep throwing and getting out of bounds.
Directing traffic. Dropping back, looking for an option, throws it, and he can't find a way to keep possession. After the incomplete pass, they'll face third down.
Here's the defense's chance to put an end to this drive. The defensive lineman will be in a full pass rush, so let's see if the guys up front can prevent the sack.
The Lions come out in a nickel package. Slings this one. The pass falls incomplete. Fourth down after he failed to connect on the pass. Smith comes into the game for the punt. Swint back to return. Here's the punt. From the 17-yard line. Well, not a bad return. It's time to see what the offense can do now as they come back out onto the field. It's first and 10. The Colts come out in a nickel package. Throwing. Incomplete pass. Tough time picking up the rush that time, and he gets off a bad throw.
Putting pressure on the quarterback can disrupt passes, but pressuring the receivers can do the same thing. If you can play physically on the outside, bump them off their routes, hold them up at the line, you can take away his receiving options, forcing him to just get rid of it.
Indianapolis looks like they're playing the pass as they're lined up in the dime. With the pass, loses one tackle, hurdles through. You can hear the collision up here.
He's feeling it right now. Either that or he's numb all over. And that's worse.
Ball on their own 36.
Talk about getting unloaded on. That's what happened here. He just got unloaded on.
That run won't move them far.
The lineman just failed to open up any holes to run through or give them room to work with.
Second and 8. They go with the run once again. Triple brings him down at the 41-yard line. The end of the second quarter with the score. Detroit 6. Indianapolis 3. So with halftime now over, let's take a look at how both teams performed in the first half. So we'll get ready to go here in the second half. Good kick should be returnable. From the 11.
This one hasn't been decided yet. Each of these teams have played fairly well on both sides of the ball. So I could see this one getting decided by whoever has the last possession.
So they have first and 10 here. James, the lone back. Pass play here on first down. With the pass. And It's complete. Bailey makes the play at the 35. Receiver showing us soft hands on that reception.
The guy's been working really hard trying to improve. Looks like all that extra work is paying dividends.
A little over four to go. Only one man in the backfield. Looks like he's calling an audible. Throws on the move. And he hits his target. They completed the pass for a first down.
They did it against the cover, too. The quarterback found a soft spot, and he got it in there.
So we have first and 10 here. James, the lone back.
Silver, 36, with the blue leg.
Pollard, the motion man. Gets rid of it. Incomplete pass. Ball was knocked out of there by a big hit.
That's what I like to see. A defensive player putting a good look at a guy to force the drop pass.
The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. Throws it. Right to him. Good throw, good catch to move the chains.
You know, as a receiver, all you have to do is get a step, and this guy's going to put the ball on you.
It's first and 10. James, the lone back. Fly makes the tackle at the 27. They went with the running play.
You never know when you're going to find some room and break loose into the secondary.
5 yards to go. Looks like he's changing the play. Throwing. And he makes the grab. Big hit there. He was run over by a truck.
Yeah, two-ton truck pulling a trailer.
He zipped that one right in there.
That's just a great job by the receiver. Not only was he able to make the catch in the rocket, but he was able to pick up some nice yardage, too.
Seventh play of this drive. In field goal range now. They weren't able to get into the red zone once in the first half, but here they are in the third, inside the 20. Get the call. And he's tackled at the 10. Picked up 9 on the play. First down marker is just inside the 9. The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. Changing the play now. Dropping back off his back foot. Perfect throw. Pollard just squeaks by the first down marker. Not the best throw we've ever seen from him, but very effective nonetheless.
That one could have spelled trouble. You got to take your time, make your read, set your feet before you get rid of it. Throwing the ball off your back foot like that could lead to some bad throws and some costly interceptions.
The quarterback lines up with two options behind him. Looks like he's calling an audible. Fullback. Home makes the stop at the 2. Tried to move the ball on the ground.
A running attack that is consistent and effective will help the offense dictate the pace of the game.
They need 2 yards to get it in the end zone. Going to the left. He hands it off. James is in there for the score. And now our viewers can see how successful each team's main running threat has been today.
Vanderjagt comes in to attempt the point after.
And it's on its way, and he tacks on the extra point.
And they move ahead after a well-orchestrated drive.
They were clicking on all cylinders that time. They found the right spot in the defense to attack.
Here's the kickoff team. And he got all of that one. A great kick.
The Lions will start the drive from the 22.
First and 10. Jones is the deep back. Hand it off. Freeney makes the stop at the 25. They went back to the run on that play.
That just goes to show you that the coach trusts the guy to hang on to the ball.
Ball on their own 25. The offense lines up with split backs behind the quarterback. Jones. He's brought down behind the line for a short loss. Jones was stuffed on that play, John.
They're just relentless when the offense decides to run the ball. They break down blocks very quickly. And they do a good job maintaining their gap assignments, limiting cutback opportunity. The offense has been stepping it up on third down all day.
With the throw, and this pass is completed. William is able to come down with it, and that completion will keep the chains moving.
I tell you, there's no substitute for picture-perfect route running.
So we have first and 10 here. Indianapolis comes out in their nickel package. He hands it off.
You know, when your running game is this ineffective, you have to look other places for offense.
It's second down and a long way to go.
Let's go, let's go. Come on and get it.
The backs are lined up in an eye. It's been a great game so far. These two teams move to the fourth quarter with the score. Indianapolis, 10. Detroit, 6.
The Lions have the ball to start this fourth quarter and can move into the lead with a touchdown.
Fifth play of this drive.
Come on now. Let's do this.
Jones, the deep man. Rodgers, the man in motion. Gives the ball off. Big pop that time.
Boom. Now that is big-time football.
Not much on that play.
Yeah, and that's what happens when you talk about a disciplined defense. They stay at home and wait for the runner to come to them.
Sixth play of this drive. 9 yards to go. Indianapolis comes out in their nickel package. With the pass behind him, and he has it. The defense blitzes the corner, but the quarterback under it quickly for a completion and a first down.
That was a great play because he saw him coming, remained calm, and threw an accurate pass.
So we have first and 10 here. Jones, the lone back, with the carry, still running. Barrett with the stop at the 42-yard line. That run didn't get them much.
Yeah, there was a defender in every gap ready to make the tackle on that play.
They have to get to the 36 to convert for a first down.
It's Simmons in motion.
Jones.
Doss records the tackle at the 27-yard line. Jones contributed with a nice game there.
The offense won the battle at the line of scrimmage, and they blew the defenders off the line, opening holes for the runner to slide right through.
Ninth play of this drive. They're within striking distance here. Pass play here on first down. Pressure flings it to the outside. Brackett records the stop at the 25-yard line. Schlesinger gets the reception, but it's only about a 2-yard pickup. The first down marker just inside the 17. Only one man back. Dropping back, throwing. And it's caught. Harper with the tackle at the 14-yard line. The touch pass finds the receiver for the first down.
And the receiver did a nice job of hauling in that high pass to get it.
It's first and 10. Harrington using split backs. Schlesinger will feel that one tomorrow.
Yeah, with how hard he just got in, he's lucky to be able to hold on to the ball.
I like how this big guy can run with the football.
Yeah, and this fullback can do more than just get out there and lead block. Give him the ball and watch him rumble.
6 yards away from a touchdown. Hand off to the tailback. Gets away. He just gets this one past the sticks. So let's take a look at how this back compares to the opposition. Four more yards to finish off the drive with a touchdown. The Colts come out with 8 guys in the box. Almost intercepted. Oh, man, he had it in the end zone, but dropped.
That's the second worst thing that can happen to a defender, to drop one like that. The absolute worst thing is to have your man beat you for 6.
14th play of this drive. Kevin Jones is in there for the touchdown. He just got it across the goal line.
Yep, he just lowered his shoulders and got the short yardage that they needed.
The lineup for the extra point. And it's up. The point after is good. The Lions are holding on to a slim lead. Rhodes, he's back for the kickoff as we take a quick glance at his return numbers. The Lions are ready to kick this one off. They'll return this one. From the 9 to the 20. The defense looks to rebound after that last effort when they allowed a touchdown. So they have first and 10 here. The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. James dropped behind the line for a loss of a couple. James couldn't find an opening and was brought down very quickly.
Yeah, he was. This line has to do a better job of holding up at the point of attack. He has a fast first step. He can explode through the hole. But he needs a line to create that little crease or cutback lane to break free.
Only one man in the backfield. With the pass, he hits his receiver. Manning will be facing a third down now after that pass nets 6. Two-minute warning coming up. Out of the shotgun. Gets rid of it, and it's complete. Nice ball going to the air, and that'll move the chains. And we've reached the two-minute mark.
The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him.
Stop behind the line. Loss of the cover.
Under pressure.
And he's taken down in the backfield. The veteran slips in there and gets the sack.
Hey, you still got to give him a lot of respect. His moves haven't diminished that much, and he still makes impact play.
They'll be faced with a long third down play here.
Troy comes out in a dime package. Looks like he's calling an audible. Dropping back, looking downfield, throwing, and he hits his target.
Harris, it stops short of the marker on that play.
And this is the seventh play of this drive.
They're in a tough spot here, but they have to go for it.
Drops back, gets the pass off, incomplete.
Watch here. This is one heck of a play by the defensive back. They were looking for a big play on fourth down, but he gets up there and knocks it away.
This one is just about in the books. Harrington with a man in motion. Jones. He just unloaded on it.
Boom. Now that is what football's all about.
Couldn't find much of a hole, and he's brought down after a gain of what looks like a couple.
Yeah, you talk about push. This line got no push at all, and there was nowhere to go.
First down marker just inside the 27. Hand it off. Slips the tackle. The 20, the 10, 5, touchdown, Detroit. So a touchdown after an unbelievable run.
He made some nice moves, put his foot on the gas, and headed right for the goal line.
Hanson comes in for the extra point. The kick is up, and he tacks on the extra point. That's 14 unanswered points.
These guys are really starting to get the momentum going in their favor.
Rose gets set to return the kickoff as we take a look at his stats. The Lions are lined up for the kickoff. Booming kick downfield. From the one. Using the stiff arm. Indianapolis needs two scores to get back into this one. It's first and 10. From the gun. Going to the air on first down. Throwing. This one falls incomplete, and they have to go to the air because they need big plays fast.
That's right. You got to have composure in these situations. Find your receivers who can pick up yardage after the catch. But most importantly, you have to keep the chains moving. The defense should focus on keeping the receiver from getting to the sideline. Because as soon as he catches the ball, that's where he's going to want to go with it.
Gets the pass off. Perfect pass. Live with the stop at the 40. Dropping back. Throwing, on the money, across midfield, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. Stokely is in there for the score. An amazing play that goes the distance.
I tell you, when he got into the open, there wasn't anyone who was going to catch him. That just shows the quick strike ability these guys have. They can put up points from anywhere on the field.
Vanderjagt comes in to attempt the point after. And it's up. The point after is good. The Colts regain the momentum of that score, John.
You can feel the momentum shifting.
As we take a look at his success returning kicks, we get ready for the kickoff. They have to get the ball back quickly, so they're going to try the onside kick. Here's the onside kick, and they don't recover it. The Lions will start this drive from the 37-yard line.
I know the coach loves it when he can tell his quarterback, just go out there for a kneel down, because that means you've got yourselves a win.
So they have first and 10 here. Looks like they'll take a knee right here and savor the victory. The Colts call a timeout. They have no timeouts left. And a kneel down here on second down is the most likely scenario. First down marker just inside the 27. So they'll just wind the clock down and get out of here with a win. Third and long. No need for anything else but taking a knee here to finish this one out. Come to the end of this one, and the score is 20-17. Kevin Jones is our horse trailer player of the game.
I'm a hot water, cornbread, chicken eating, classic whip driving